Today is for Karen. Carpenter, that is.
Mr. Gouda, say Mr. Gouda, may I have a moment?
Although the Carpenters were criticised in the 70s for being square and middle of the road, the sheer quality of their music has guaranteed its survival.
Mr. Gouda, say Mr. Gouda, I have seen you go through a day.
In recent years, a new generation of Carpenters' disciples, like Sonic Youth and Badly Drawn Boy, have finally declared them hip.
I definitely think it's the kind of music that is closer to me than a lot of the more contemporary so-called cool stuff.
Look at the careers of most bands. I mean, one iconic song is a lot. So I guess 12, just to leave 12 perfect pop moments there, frozen in time, that's what makes them extra magical.
Maybe part of their legacy goes to inform people about, you know, what's cool, what isn't cool. Eventually, music does just stand on its own, and it can influence people, you know, Sonic Youth to British popsters.
When I heard that vocal, long ago and so far, I thought, that's the most bizarre thing I've ever heard in my life. But it was funny, I thought Richard would be upset, and he said, oh no, I worked on it.
All of a sudden, it was hip. Supposedly.
Your guitar, it sounds so sweet and clear.
It's actually really important to not forget about Karen. And her voice won't let us forget about her because it's so big.
It'll live forever. You know, good stuff just doesn't fade away. It just gets bigger and bigger and better and better.
It's something I know would have made Karen very happy and very proud, that what we accomplished back then is still finding such a following today.
He feels that what he is doing, what he's done subsequently, is what she might want him to do. I know she'd say, get off of your butt and do what you gotta do. And that's what he's doing.
Guys, I want to really start slowing it down more in the tag, 97.8.
Oh, well, I don't look at those notes that low. I'll never get down there.
Now married with 5 children, in the 20 years since Karen's death, Richard has concentrated his energies on preserving the Carpenters' musical legacy. Without his sister's great voice to accompany him, he was understandably reluctant to work with other singers, apart from Dionne Warwick and the late Dusty Springfield. But this year, he's writing new songs, and he's back in the studio working with old friends such as Joe Osborne and Petula Clark.
I should know that after 40 years, if you never learn.
It's going, man. Same spot. It's really been a creative time for me, a good time, working on a Christmas album. Petula Clark is one of the guest vocalists, and Petula is singing as well as ever.
As someone who's worked with him recently, it is an amazing experience. It's not easy, but it's good.
I wish Karen was around, because he hasn't changed at all. When you work with Rich, it's real subtle how he gets not only what he wants, but the best out of you.
Right off the bat, I can slow that down. That's too fast. And now any number of emotions go through my mind. A lot of it is just how quickly time goes and how long it's been since some of those records were recorded. And then, of course, the tragedy of Karen's problem, that she was really struck down at such a tender age. You do think about how much more you could have accomplished and how much more music was in the two of us. We've come almost no distance at all in any sort of understanding or cure. with eating disorders, which is another highly frustrating thing.